They're getting arrested.
Still got his hands up.
I may have to.
Ouch.
Yeah.
It says, if I speak in tongues of men and angels, but I do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophecy and know all mysteries and all knowledge,
That's okay.
And if I have faith, if I have all the faith, so, and all the knowledge, that I can move mountains, but do not have love, I have nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I give away over my body in order to boast, but do not have love, I receive no benefit. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not envious. Love does not brag. It is not puffed up. It is not rude. It is not self-serving. It is not easily angered or resentful. It is not glad about injustice, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things.
Maybe that'll give a break in the ice there.
So, what does that passage mean? It means if you put love into your marriage, it will last. So how do you put love into your marriage? Is you put Jesus Christ into your marriage. From the beginning. Because you need all these qualities in the passage and more. You will need forgiveness, humbleness, strength, passion, guidance. But most of all, you need unconditional love. So I guess, if y'all please invite Jesus into y'all's marriage every day to build y'all up and to bless you. So he can build you up to something that's unbreakable.
It's so awesome. It's so awesome.
So, the pastor says, you can have everything but still be lacking in love and you have nothing. You can have a marriage and not have love and you will be lacking. But he tells at the end of the passage that if you put love into it, it will endure all things in your marriage. So let God's light through shine through y'all's marriage and let him truly bless y'all. And so you can be a light to everybody that looks at y'all's marriage, y'all relationship, to know it can be done. And like it says in the passage, so it will endure